The municipality of Mansalay in Negros Oriental becomes the latest to declare a state of calamity due to damage caused by the El Nino weather phenomenon. The local government said an estimated 400 million pesos in crops have gone to waste because of the dry spell. The mayor of Mansalay now urging government to provide them with more support to deal with El Nino. Four other municipalities in Oriental Mindoro had earlier been placed under a state of calamity, also because of the dry spell. Philippine transport regulators reiterate the importance of the PUV modernization program as they welcome the Supreme Court's decision to junk a petition challenging the controversial government scheme. The LTFRB asserts more operators have consolidated their franchises after failing to see anything wrong with the program.
Walang katotohanan yan dahil ang PUVMP po ay importante po para isulong natin ang ating modernization program para naman ho mas maging maganda at maging safe yung mga sasakyan po natin. Kung napansin po natin sa Southeast Asia, pila tayo na lang po atang napag-iwanan at umunlad na po ang mga ibang kapitbahay natin sa kanilang mga pangpublikong sasakyan. We need to modernize our jeepneys to make them safe and comfortable and accessible public transportation. And the only way to do that is to modernize our transportation system. From the 76%, umabot na po kami sa 80% ng mga nag-consolidate. Nalaman po ng mga tumututol dito na tila wala hong kahantungan yung kanilang pagtutol dahil ang gobyerno ho ay desidido pong isulong ang programa. Number two ho, nakita ho nila na ang programa ay hindi ho oppressive at wala hong layunin na tanggalin yung mga lumang jeepney kaagad, and they are given at least 3 to 4 years to modernize. And then number three, meron hong assistance na binibigay ang ating pamahalan po in terms of equity subsidy or down payment. So nung nakita nila ho yung ganda ng programa.
President Marcos calls for the end of gender-based violence, discrimination, and biases on International Women's Day. In a statement, Marcos said he wants to see those things removed from society as they cast shadows over the realization of women's dreams. He also urged the public to amplify the voices of women because he believes doing so would lift the Philippine community as a whole. Senator J.V. Ejercito explaining his decision to withdraw support from an objection to the contempt order against troubled televangelist Apollo Quibuloy. Ejercito said he initially backed Senator Robin Hood Padilla's objection to the contempt order issued by panel chairperson Senator Risa Hontiveros over Quibuloy's snubbing of their probe. But Ejercito changed his mind, saying there might be another way to convince the Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader to appear before the Senate.
That was the day that Secretary of Justice Boyeng Remulla announced that cases will already be filed against Pastor Quibuloy by the DOJ for procedural practicality. He said that since DOJ will already file, then probably there's no more need for to continue the investigation. But okay. Senator Risa Ontiveros in the lounge said that Senator Nancy Binay suggested why not just online, no, for security purposes. She said that can be considered as long as Pastor Quibuloy acknowledges the committee.
Ejercito assures Quibuloy he will be treated fairly if he attends the inquiry into his alleged crimes. The pastor is accused of sexual abuse and human trafficking by former members of his group.